All water is dusk, or light blanched. A mauve shade, some water is so large it fills up the lens, becoming mere thought occurring here or there as if in a place which was chosen for it, on a surface, in a container, inside an edge. Close up, green bars of water greet an eye blinking as it turns transparent, partial. On moving skin here a body lunges on, diminishing. In shocks some water is a mask, the cover of a cave which has no walls and which flows, unawares, round points, indentations, grooves, visages. Surfacing faces look out like people in a car which has braked, swinging round, in a crash. Other are caught wading, motionless like stilts, while a lozenge-shaped launch lifts in swayed water. But the water is silent. Browsing on itself only its frontiers are audible events, as in weed suck and rock's knife cuts, with a mechanism of hands and arms heaving through it to striped boys at eye level. One side you find dark patches, a house's old mirrors, tarnished by salt wind. Midway, a white post soars, the water swirls past it, glistening, breathing, as expectantly as a birthday child. A table further on, elbows flash from one blue ridge to the next for what is it here which moves to bright to see, like a gang of Rosellas, plummeting from a brank into a wispy, mud-cracked stubble? What moves in multiples, consistent, winged, making involuntary structures out of scattered, minimal beats? It is water. Water under dryness. A plane of light, now a series of retreating fringes, or flanges perhaps, like a cloth held over a fire which burns through at several points and thus reshapes itself. First a net, the swimmer pulls himself through its white flame, then a kind of membrane folding back and up which twists out new slops, connected hillsides. Of itself, dazzled ocean floods the mind's tombs, linking them like shots framed in sleep. It's a dream sped up to unseeable quickness. It's the kind of dream which a sleeper wakes from recalling only a tone, or the muffled flight of a thing, not the scene or the face's meaning. Whatever words there were slip by like a forward darting glance wise to the touch. You focus again, sea lion clouds peer up over a ragged ledge, part of a cliff line which is no time for color. The place is now mandala, now perhaps montage, where a bed explodes in its cauldron of ripples, themselves suggesting a fish's back sliding under, or a shoulder curving through sculpted cups, or water becoming dusk, or light blanched.